Welcome to Kari's Conscious Living.
Please subscribe. The button's down there. Can you see it? On your right. Right there. Yes, that's it. Thank you so much. Welcome to the family. Are you ready to meditate with Kari? To lay down and be still and quiet and listen to the story? The story is all about helping you to be still and quiet and be focused. Focused on your body, focused on relaxing, focused on generally lots of things. Let me explain. RJ was awesome. He was just awesome. He was cool, he was funny, he was very intelligent, he was kind and sweet, he was just an all-round good boy. There was one thing that he did have a little bit of trouble with though. That was staying focused. Sometimes he just thought there was too much things to focus on all at once. Sometimes he had a very hard time just focusing on one thing, being still and quiet and listening. It was very difficult when you've got 10 million things, 10 million cool things to listen to. Who can do that? No one. RJ had a t-shirt that was no ordinary t-shirt, but he didn't know this at first. He just thought his mom bought him a cool t-shirt. The t-shirt was a black t-shirt, and on the front it said focused in giant letters, and then underneath in smaller writing it said on being me. He thought it was a cool t-shirt. He didn't realize that the first time he would wear it, his life would completely change. RJ was getting ready for school. He put on his new t-shirt, his black t-shirt that said focused in big bold letters on being me. He wore his jeans and his trainers, and he got his backpack on ready for school, and he was taking the bus to school just like any other ordinary day when he started to get this like funny feeling in his tummy. A funny feeling that all of a sudden, as he stared out of the window, things kind of started to go into, how would I say it, their own little packages. For example, he was focused on the trees, just the trees. He wasn't focusing on the trees, the cars, the streets, the people, the houses. No, he was focusing on just a little pocket, one little thing at a time, and that was the trees. He noticed this because the next thing he did was focus on all the people talking on the bus. Nothing else. He wasn't staring out of the window. He wasn't being distracted by the cars, distracted by the birds in the sky, or distracted by anything else. All he could do was just hear the pocket, the little pocket of voices talking on the bus. All the different voices having different conversations. But he could really focus on that, and he could really listen to each conversation. This was not like him at all. The next thing he noticed was he got off the bus and he decided to listen to his feet as he walked to the classroom. He could actually hear his feet. The little pocket of noise coming from his stomping feet on the ground was all he was focused on. It was very weird. Normally, like I said, RJ focused on all sorts of things, all at once, which could, to outsiders, look as if he was very unfocused, because when you're trying to focus on 10 million things, like I said, it can be very difficult to just listen to one pocket of thing, or one pocket of information, or action, or whatever it is that's going on in front of you. RJ got into the classroom. He sat down at his desk, put his backpack on his chair, and noticed that when he wanted to, he could just focus on the teacher and everything his teacher was saying. Normally, he tries to listen to his teacher, but then he gets distracted by the kids on the table. He gets distracted by staring out of the window and looking at what's outside. He gets distracted by his nails on his fingers and he chomps on them for a minute. And then he thinks about, oh, maybe what he's going to have for his lunch. He's just always thinking and focusing on more things at once than just that one thing. But today, they were just little pockets of things to focus on solely on their own. It was very weird. It was very, very weird. It happened to him all day long. It happened to him when he got home. He just focused on his dinner. It happened to him when he was doing his homework. He just focused on his homework. It happened to him when he was tidying his bedroom. He just tidied his bedroom. Finally came to taking off his new t-shirt, getting undressed, having a shower, putting his PJs on, and all of a sudden, he was focusing on 10 million things once again. 10 million things all at once. RJ didn't figure out until it was the next time he wore his t-shirt, where it happened all over again. He could focus on just one thing at a time because of his magical t-shirt. RJ's t-shirt was magical. It had magical powers that helped him to slow his mind down and focus on just one thing at a time. After this happened, after he figured out his t-shirt had magical powers, he talked to his mum, Jen, about it. And his mum was like, I didn't know that. I just thought it was a cool t-shirt. RJ didn't quite believe this. He thought his mum was up to something. But no, his mum had absolutely no clue that his t-shirt had magical powers. RJ wore that t-shirt as much as he possibly could. He wore it every time he had a test at school. He wore it every time he did his homework. He wore it every time he needed to focus on something and keep his mind calm and relaxed and focused on that pocket of just one thing at a time. Eventually, over a few months, RJ's t-shirt was getting a bit old, a little bit worn, until eventually he couldn't find it one day. He lost his magical t-shirt. He was devastated. It was like the end of the world. How was he going to be able to do his math test at school that day without his magical t-shirt? Luckily, his mum, being very smart, had bought him another t-shirt exactly the same. What a relief. RJ put the t-shirt on, but he could tell. His mind was all over the place. He was focusing on 10 million different things. It wasn't the same. It wasn't doing any magic. He fell to his knees in his bedroom. What am I gonna do? And then he had an idea. He had an idea that if his magical t-shirt was magical, what was the magic that was happening when he wore it? He walked through the steps in his mind. He noticed that when he wore his magical t-shirt, he could just focus on one thing at a time. He decided, what if I try it without my magical t-shirt? I can do this. I'm smart enough. I can stay focused enough. Because I'm me. I'm focused on being me, just like the t-shirt said. RJ went to school. He practiced on the bus. He focused very, 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 very intently on listening just to the conversations on the bus and not being distracted by the cars or the birds or whatever was going on elsewhere outside. He noticed that if he kept his breathing nice and calm and slow, just a little bit slower than normal, maybe also it was easier when he closed his eyes. He closed his eyes and listened and breathed and stayed calm and just told himself internally, stay focused on just one thing. Stay focused on the conversations. That's it. Don't get distracted. So he had this conversation in his own mind the whole time. It worked. When he got to school, he did the same thing. He took deep breaths. He calmed himself down. He got centered and balanced with his breathing. And then, when he needed to, he just closed his eyes for a few seconds. Stay focused on the test. Stay focused on each question. Stay focused on one thing at a time. Whenever he felt himself drifting off and his attention flying somewhere else in the classroom, he just closed his eyes and took a breath. Talked to himself internally. You can do this, RJ. Stay focused on one question at a time. You can do this. You're awesome. RJ figured out he didn't need a magical t-shirt. He needed the magical t-shirt at first to help him, to show him the skills that he needed to stay focused. But eventually, he didn't really need the t-shirt. He just needed the skills. And he had them. He had the skills the whole time and he just didn't realize because he was allowing himself to focus on 10 billion things at once instead of just one thing at a time. Once he figured it out, RJ was a genius. He was good to go. He was focused. Just focused on being him. The end.